My friends, not just in Zambia but across Zambia, to my YouTube channel where I'll be posting some songs from my album, and also I'll be posting some teachings. So please, let's keep on interacting. If you watch me, please make sure that you subscribe, you share the video. This is your brother, your son, your friend, even Apostle Jonas Kapisa. I want to encourage you this afternoon, today, on a word of God, which it will shape the book of Romans chapter 8, verse 38, the writings of Paul. He said, "For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present and things to come, or height, nor other creature will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord." I want to tell you that we are permanently in love with Jesus Christ. We are permanently loved by God. We are loved so much. Now, Paul, an apostle like me, he wrote something to the world, to you and me, that there's nothing in this world, those things that are here, that can separate us. That even though you die, that's why he said in one word, he says, "For me to die is gain, to live is Christ." So nothing, is it poverty, is it angels, is it today, is it tomorrow? What is there that can help you? There's nothing that can separate you from the love of God. Separate you. But at the same time, it doesn't mean the word of God is contradicting on its own. No, it doesn't contradict, because I've got another writing from the prophet now. This is an apostle now. That thing that can separate you. It means one person. He says, "Behold," Isaiah 59 verse 1, "Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, nor his ear heavy that it cannot hear. But your iniquities have separated between you and your God, and your sins have hidden his face from you so that he cannot hear you." So now, the prophet has found the only thing that can separate, and that is the very thing that Jesus followed, that he came to deal with, which is the work of the devil, which is sin. You can be poor, you can be naked, you can be rejected, you can be abandoned, but God is still with you, be with you. But if you live in sin, sin is the bitter root of all evil. Sicknesses, poverty, whatever that you want to talk about. That's why some people came to Jesus. They wanted to get healing. Instead of saying you are healed, Jesus was saying your sins are forgiven, which provoked the Philistines. Why he was saying your sins are forgiven? Why? Sin is the root cause. We are all suffering because Adam and Eve, they sinned against God. Child of God, may you be washed away from your sins. Be washed away from your sins, and then God will bless you. God will bless and you prosper in your soul, in your spirit, and everything that you do, you prosper. And at the end of the day, you're going to receive a gift during judgment, the eternal life. God will accept you. God will bless you. So please, nothing can separate you, but there is one, which is called sin. In Bemba, they say, "Uluwembu," in Ilozi, "CV." Sin is very bad. It will deaden, it will make sure that God throw you in the lake of fire. So please be washed. Be washed by the spiritual water called the blood of Jesus. Once again, this was your friend, your brother, and the servant of the Lord, Apostle Jonas Kapisa. I feel I should encourage you this. So please, I beg you, God bless you. Don't fear anything, but fear God and fear sin.